Hello and welcome. Would you like to learn how to parse a CSV file in Power Automate and generate documents in bulk, all with the help of Plumsail Documents? Let me show you how. Let's say we want to generate conference invitations for a large list of clients, so we later can print and mail them. So here we have this CSV file with client contact information stored in a OneDrive folder. However, you can use other storages such as SharePoint, Google Drive, Dropbox, etc. Let's take a look. For the sake of this tutorial, there are only a few contacts, but of course you can have hundreds of them. Next, let's take a look at the invitation template. It's a Word document that we are going to convert into a PDF later in the video. Please take a look at the tokens. Tokens are special placeholders enclosed in double curly brackets, and they will be dynamically replaced by data pulled from our CSV file. Don't worry, we're going to take a thorough look at the tokens later in the video. Let's create our Power Automate flow. First, we are going to create an instant cloud flow. You can pick any trigger, but this time we will select manually trigger a flow, so we simplify the process. Let's give it a name, for example, generating invitations PDF. Click create. Next, we need to get the content from the CSV file with contacts. First, we select OneDrive and then get file content. We click on the folder icon and select the file. Let's rename the step to get CSV content so it's easier to find it in one of the next steps. Next, we follow the same steps to get content from our Word template. We'll rename this step as well. Now we need to connect to Plumsail Documents and find the parse CSV action. If this is your first time connecting to Plumsail Documents, you will need to establish a connection by creating an API key in your Plumsail account. To create the API key, we need to go back to our Plumsail account, click on Documents. On the left, we can see API keys, click Add Key. Let's give a name, for example, Power Automate, because that's where we're connecting. Click Create. Now we copy the secret key, go back to Power Automate. Paste, create, and we're all set. After we have established the connection, we need to complete our parse CSV action. In the content of CSV document field, we select get CSV file content. And in the headers field, specify the headers from your CSV file. In our case, we're going to parse ID, first name, last name, company, and email. In the next step, we need to find another Plumsail document connector called Create DOCX Document from Template. And in the Template file field, we need to select Get DOCX Template Content to pull our invitation template. The next field is called Template Data, and it is an object that will be applied to our DOCX template. In our case, we're applying just two columns from our CSV file to the template. It is first name and last name. Earlier in this video, we mentioned tokens when we were looking at the invitation template, remember? So first name and last name in quotation marks are those exact tokens. And now we're associating them with the columns from the parsed CSV file. In the document output type, you can choose between PDF or you can keep it in the DOCX format. We are going to convert it to the PDF. And in our last step, we will save our bulk generated PDF invitations in a OneDrive folder. First, we need to add an action inside the Create DOCX Document from Templates tab. So we click Add Action. Next, connect to OneDrive and find Create File Action. And select a OneDrive folder where you want your invitations to be saved. For the file name field, we apply company column from our CSV file, and we add .pdf extension. You can choose any column that works for you, such as email or ID. In the file content field, insert result file from the same step. Click save. Now let's run the flow. Now let's go back to OneDrive and see if our invitations were saved successfully. And as you can see, they're all in the folder we have specified. Let's open one of them. And just like that, the tokens were replaced by the data pulled from our CSV file. The simple automation process can help you save time and effort when you're working with documents. And drop us a comment below if you're struggling with document-related tasks in your organization. Feel free to share your case and we'll demonstrate how to automate it in one of our future videos. And if you haven't tried Plumsail Documents yet, we offer a free 30-day trial that offers a full set of features so you can tackle those tedious tasks with the help of automation.